Hello dear students, today we are going to discuss about the governors. Basically, the function of governors and classification of governors and the centrifugal governor. So function of a governor is to regulate the mean speed of an engine when there are variations in the load. The governor automatically controls the supply of working fluid to the engine with the varying load conditions and keeps the mean speed within the certain limit. And there are different type of governors, centrifugal governor and inertia governor. Centrifugal governor is further divided into pendulum type governor and loaded type governor. Pendulum type governor, that means watt governor, and loaded type is further divided into two type of governor, that is dead weight governors and spring controlled governors. Dead weight governor is also having portal governor and proil governor, and spring controlled governors are the Hartnell governor, Harton governor, Wilson Hartnell governor and Pickering governor. So we will discuss in this unit, we will discuss about all type of these governors. And before discuss about the what governor, we have to discuss about the centrifugal governor. So now the centrifugal governor. So this is the schematic diagram of centrifugal governor. Centrifugal governors are based on balancing of centrifugal force on the rotating balls by equal and opposite radial force. That force is known as a controlling force. It consists of two balls. These are the first one is and this one is the second balls of equal mass which are attached to the arms as shown in this figure you can see here. These balls are also known as governor balls. The balls revolve with a spindle which is driven by the engine through the wheel gears. The upper end of the arms are pivoted to the spindle so that the balls may be rise up or fall down as they revolve about the vertical axis. The arms are connected by the links to the sleeve which is key to the spindle. This sleeve revolves with the spindle but can slide up and down. The balls and the sleeve rise when the spindle speed increases and falls when the speed decreases. In order to limit the travel of the sleeve in upward or downward direction, two stoppers are also provided, which is denoted by capital S. When the load on the engine increases, the engine and the governor speed decreases. This results in decrease of centrifugal force on the balls. Hence, the balls move inward and the sleeve moves downward. The downward movement of the sleeve operates a throttle valve at the other end. And this throttle valve is operated with the help of this bell crank lever to increase the supply of working fluid, and thus the engine speed is increased. In this case, the extra power output is provided to balance the increased load. When the load on the engine decreases, the engine and the governor speed increases, which results in the increase of centrifugal force on the balls. Thus, the balls move outwards and sleeve rises upward. This upward movement of the sleeve reduces the supply of working fluid. Hence, the speed is decreased. In this case, the power output is reduced. So this is the simple working principle of centrifugal governor. Thank you.